This beautiful sunset at Venice Beach, California is captured by two RED Komodo 6K cinematic cameras side by side in 6K 30 frames per second, up converted into 60 frames per second using optical flow from Revision Twixtor and stitched in Mexican VR. This is a VR180 video, so you should really watch this in your favorite VR headset, like the brand new Oculus Quest 2 or Pico Neo 2 to see 3D in the highest resolution. The purpose of this video is to show you that it is totally possible to create beautiful cinematic 3D 180 videos with two RED Komodo to saturate the max resolution of the brand new Oculus Quest 2, which is 7200 by 3600 in 60 frames per second. We are going to show you a side-by-side comparison between the two RED Komodo and another popular professional VR 180 camera, the Zcam K2 Pro. We will explain when to use the K2 Pro and when to use the RED Komodo setup based on the IPD requirement. The RED Komodo is a beautiful camera and unlocks so many possibilities for professional VR content creators and filmmakers. And it is about time we use traditional Hollywood-approved cinema camera to level up our VR production. As the leading expert in VR180 filmmaking, your boy Hugh here is working hard to figure out the build, the post-production for you, free with love, so you can wow your clients and your audience in the next level immersion. If you want to support what I do for you, don't forget to subscribe and give this video a thumb up and share it on your social media. Now, let's rewatch the action part and answer the most obvious question. Why are you Twixtor to up convert the frame rate from 30 frames per second to 60 frames per second? Well, RED Komodo can only shoot at 30 frames per second in 6K. We want the max resolution close to 4K per eyes, so we have to shoot at 30 frames per second. Yes, the fish eyes crop your sensor as well, so you don't get the full 6K. 60 frames per second is very important for cinematic VR video in the Oculus Quest 2. It should be the new standard moving forward. Take a look at 30 frames per second and 60 frames per second comparison in your Oculus Quest. You will see the differences immediately. The ghosting effect is what causing motion sickness for lots of people. For more information about frame rate and resolution, please refer to my Oculus Quest 2 Max Resolution Explained video right here. Lots of useful technical information. You may think Revision Twixtor will create lots of artifacts when doing optical flow interpretation. Yes, for other rolling shutter cameras like the Instar360 Titan or Blackmagic 6K, but not for RED Komodo, which is a global shutter cinema camera. This is the most underrated but also the most important feature of RED Komodo. Having a global shutter camera meaning you can easily use optical flow to stabilize shaky footage to avoid gyro effects, or in this case, is to create extra frames to have a smooth experience in VR. But if you do not want to rely on post-production to create extra frames, RED Komodo can shoot 4K in 60 frames per second. Here is the result we shot at 4K in 60 frames per second during a Fox PBC boxing match. We use the RED Komodo professionally for broadcast in VR because we trust RED. The RED Komodo can reach Zcam K2 Pro max resolution in 5.7K in 60 frames per second by shooting direct side-by-side to use the entire Super 35mm sensors. If you look up and down, you do see a black circle, but it is okay if you integrate a 3D environment to cover the black hole, just like Oculus Venue with its VIP viewing room. Having 16-bit color depth and reliability is so important for broadcast or just any professional environment when you do not control the lighting. Working on raw R3D is so efficient compared to over-compressed H.265 like from the Instar360 Titan. It gives RED a unique advantage that no other VR camera can ever come close. What about the IPD? In this boxing video, the IPD is actually huge, 111mm to be precise. Do you see an issue? Is that make you look like King Kong? Is that make you sick? I asked lots of people to watch this video in my Oculus Quest 2. Not even one person mentioned discomfort. So for far away action sport, large IPD is totally fine. Sometimes it is what you want when the action are really far away and losing stereo 3D effects. But what about close up, like what you see right here? Our beautiful actress is smelling the flower for narrative content. Well, the RED Komodo can shoot side by side thanks to global shutter to bring down the IPD distance to 19mm to 95mm. It is still bigger than 65mm, which is the average IPD distance. But how is that look really compared to Zcam K2 Pro? Let's do a tight space side-by-side comparison to find out. Here we have the RED Komodo in its smallest IPD configuration without breaking the camera in 7K 30 frames per second up converted to 60 frames per second. I have to downscale it to 5.7K just to match the K2 Pro resolution in a single video. So please download this video on my Google Drive and silo it onto your Oculus Quest 2 to see the final uncompressed result. I have done a lot of works and shared lots of free resources to you, so please, if you find this useful, drop a like and thank you comment down below. I will have a follow-up to the video to share my thought, what I think among the three cameras, the K2 Pro, the RED Komodo, and even the Blackmagic 6K, in terms of image quality, 3D disparity, and workflow complexity. So don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell. In conclusion, I want to say the RED Komodo is a fantastic camera for future VR production. It might not be appropriate for close-up VR180, but definitely a great system for hyperstereo, far away 3D to make everything pop. It is also a great camera for broadcast or mission-critical production. RED told me they are seriously considering breaking the shell open and put the two brains together to create something like the K2 Pro, which is essentially two Zcam E2. This will bring down the IPD even further, but this requires the VR community to express enough interest. That is why it is so important to share this video and comment below to provide feedbacks. Let's together push the medium forward by continuing to innovate, do something that has never been done before, and tell amazing immersive stories. I will see you next time.